Hello from Australia. Earlier in the week in Brisbane at an event with William Lane Craig, one of the things I showed was a video. It was to demonstrate that many of the things that Dr. Craig says or claims to say with great authority are either incorrect or disingenuous. In particular, this particular video related to a movie we made called The Unbelievers, which has not yet been distributed. Now, Dr. Craig did not one, not two, but three podcasts about the movie, which shocked me at the time since it hadn't been distributed. What shocked me more when I listened to it, of course, was the fact that lots of statements are made there that are factually incorrect, claims about the movie that are simply untrue, claims of what was said in the movie that are completely wrong. Now, the listeners to this podcast would have no access to this because, of course, the movie hasn't been distributed. Now, after the fact, Dr. Craig came up to me and made an excuse for why at least one of the mistakes was made, and I pointed out to him that excuse didn't hold water, and I was going to leave it at that. But Dr. Craig has now posted his excuse, and therefore I feel it's absolutely necessary perhaps to call him out on it, because it's reprehensible, really. So Dr. Craig said that the mistake was made because, in fact, they didn't see the movie, but they had an audio tape of it, which must be pirated because no audio tapes exist, but we'll get to that in a second. Now, he claimed that because it was an audio tape, he didn't know who was saying what, and therefore he was incorrect about inferring this. And in fact, he inferred, as he says at great lengths, that Richard Dawkins set up Cardinal Pell in a program called Q&A, a conversation between the two of them, set him up to make him look bad. And he goes on and on about how disingenuous and inappropriate and rude this was. And this is what he claims the transcript of the movie says. Question: do you believe that human beings are evolved from apes? Answer: probably so. Question: well then, do you believe that human beings are evolved from Neanderthals? Answer: probably so. And he goes on, Dr. Craig, to say, see, of course humans aren't evolved from Neanderthals, and Richard Dawkins was just setting up Cardinal Pell to make him look bad. Well, first of all, of course, the question wasn't asked by Richard Dawkins, but even aside from that, the transcript is not what Dr. Craig says it was. Here's the actual transcript. Question: do you accept that humans evolved from apes? Answer: yeah, probably. From Neanderthals, yes. One question, one answer. It turns out the question was asked by Tony Jones, the moderator. But there's no setting up here. There's none of that. And in fact, the argument that Dr. Craig then gave me that we didn't know who was saying what just doesn't hold water, because in fact, the quotation is not from the movie. And so you may have not known who was saying what, but you should be able to hear it. But that points to another real problem. This is a pirated audio tape. Who does, first of all, not one, not two, but three podcasts and one review on a movie that they haven't even seen? That itself is, at best, disingenuous. I can think of other words. But worse than that, it's a pirated audio tape, so it's actually, in principle, theft as well as lying about the movie. And to be proud of it and to write a piece about it is something that I find amazing for a man who claims to be ethical. Now, it's even worse than that, because Dr. Craig claims then that they retracted the podcast when they knew there was a mistake. Well, if you go to any site of any reasonable journalist, if there's a mistake, and I write for the New York Times, if there's a mistake in a piece, they publish an errata, say the original piece was wrong. Those people who read it should know there was a mistake. Do you know that if you go to Dr. Craig's site? No. Anyone who listens to that podcast now, or anyone who listened to the original version and didn't choose to go back and listen to it again, would have no idea that a huge mistake was made in the original podcast. That is disingenuous. That kind of unethical, disingenuous statement with great pompous claims to be moral and ethical is something that is problematic, let me say. And I think one tends to find that in many of the other statements of Dr. Craig. The actual clips are now shown here for your entertainment.
For example, there's a very, I think, uncharitable exchange between Dawkins and Cardinal Pell concerning evolutionary theory, where Dawkins clearly tries to set Pell up to embarrass him. He says to him, do you believe that human beings are evolved from apes? And Pell answers, probably so. And then Dawkins says, do you believe then that human beings are evolved from Neanderthals? And Pell says, probably so. And then Dawkins springs the trap. Well, that shows you don't understand evolutionary theory because Neanderthals are not ancestors of human beings, of Homo sapiens. They are our cousins, not our ancestors, attempting to show Pell's ignorance of evolutionary theory. This was clearly an attempt by Dawkins to simply set up and embarrass an opponent in an unfair way.
George Pell.
Do you accept that humans evolved from apes?
Yeah, probably. From Neanderthals, yes. Whether...
From Neanderthals?
Probably.
Why from Neanderthals?
Well, who else would you suggest?
Bill, another point is Krauss's statement about Darwin. Krauss said that Darwin showed the origin of life is not a miracle.
Isn't that a remarkable statement? Darwin showed that the origin of life is not a miracle. Darwin had nothing to say about the origin of life. So this is just a scientific error on Krauss's part in this film.
Some similarity. Before Darwin, life was a miracle. You couldn't ask the question, where did the diversity of life come from? It was a miracle. It was designed. What Darwin showed were very simple laws of biology. Natural selection and genetic mutation, essentially, could produce all the diversity on life, of life, the complexity we now see, from very simple beginnings, with no miracle. Now, at the time he did it prove it? No. But it was plausible. Now there's been 150 years of proof. Now we take it the next step. Do we know how the first forms of life started? Absolutely not. But it's certainly plausible that, given everything we know about genetics, biochemistry, that chemistry by natural processes can turn into biology. Do we know that? No, but it's plausible, and that's worth celebrating, that you don't need miracles.
We see this same sort of besmirching of people's character when Krauss says near the film's conclusion, at a funeral, people cry when their loved ones are gone. Why? Because they don't really believe that they'll see their loved one again. They're just liars. They're deceiving themselves and others. Well, Kevin, this is just an idiotic analysis.
I think people don't really believe the myths they invent. I've been to many funerals in which the priest has spoken of an afterlife, and even the people who are there are sobbing profusely. They don't really think they're going to meet their loved one in 5 years' time. If, on the other hand, you stood on the quayside and watched Queen Mary set off for New York, the people on the quayside are not crying because they know they're going to see those people again fairly soon. A funeral is fundamentally different, yet it should be the same.
The film actually has very little critique of religion in it. Instead, it simply extols science. Richard Dawkins has one memorable line near the end of the film. He says, I'm in love with science, and I want to tell the world.
Carl Sagan said, when you're in love, you want to tell the world. And Sagan said, I'm in love with science, and I have to tell the world.